دلوقتي in Bali, in the middle of the rice fields. My name is Sora. I'm a journalist, Egyptologist, doing sound healing for close to 3 years. دلوقتي. I think 9 found me more than I found it. It was a time in my life where I was really stimulated by Cairo, overstimulated. I wanted somewhere that would be kind of quiet, but that would just expose me to sound that's not music. And I just randomly found it on Instagram, and I started practicing with Shireen a couple of years ago, and completely changed my life. Like in the last couple of months, I was struggling with a lot of things, and I wanted greenery. And by complete chance, I also joke and I say that Bali called out to me, because when the call for this trip started, I was like, oh, now's the right time for it. I need all the healing and greenery and sort of serenity I can amass. I love practicing with them, genuinely. I really do, Yani. Shireen's sound healing is so restorative, and it gives you so much inner peace. I sleep so well at night, but also it literally clears me of all of like the tension that I always have in my life. And then Seva has such a soothing way of getting people to practice yoga. Them together make for such a nice team. And at the end of it, you really come out of the retreats feeling super energized and like more connected to yourself. I would recommend it to everyone, honestly. And I would recommend it to people who have done the inner work on themselves, but also people who just need to kind of disconnect from their daily life and from like the hustle and bustle and the daily grind, and who just need to just get more rooted. Yeah, people who need to reconnect with themselves, like who have maybe lost their sense of self from daily life and work and family and stress. I think it's a great opportunity for anyone who wants to like do baby steps, like make baby steps towards changing their lives.
Dina Fahmy. يعني بحب اعرف نفسي من فنان اول حاجه تيجي في مخي نعمل ريتريت يوجا وساوند هيل اولا بالي كانت في الباكت ليست بتاعتي بقالها سنين والاوبورتيونيتي دي ما بتجيش كتير بلس جت في ميعاد مظبوط قوي I really felt ان انا in need of this لما تحس انك عايزه تفضي كده عايزه تبقي جوه نفسك analyze deep بتبقي في اتموسفير بعيد عن الحياه الروتينيه اليوميه بتفيد في انك بتشحني البطاريه جدا ويبقى عندك استعداد بعدها انك تدي لان فقد الشيء لا يعطيه لو بطاريتك على 0% او 5 او 10 it's impossible to give فلما بتيجي هنا you really recharge and you feel better and you feel energized لأني جربت قبل كده ساوند هيلينج معاه في ريتريتس تانية وفي أماكن تانية يعني ساحل في دهشور and it's an amazing experience amazing بمعنى كلمة amazing الفايب دي اللي بتطلع وازاي it resonates وازاي بيجيلك كده أفكار وأحاسيس مختلفة خالص وسيبا لأني عارفة إنها بتعمل يوجا in a very subtle easy and يعني اي حد يقدر يعملها بلس انها she has a lot of wisdom برضه و I would recommend it to anyone who's willing to work on himself يعلى one step او يفتح باب قدامه انا حاسه ان انا في زياره الى الجنه بجد بس انا بعتقد ان الجنه والنار على الارض فيعني البريفليج والتميز ده والاحساس بانك في مكان زي ده الفيزيت تو بارادايس رسمي يعني جمال ما حصلش مناظر طبيعية ما حصلتش كنت أعرف شيرين من سنة وصبا كنت أعرفها بس فيرتشوال الباقي كله ناس جديدة بالنسبة لي بس very nice group ومبسوطة جدا ان انا عملت الخطوة دي بصراحة.
Me too. Yes. Thank you.
Thank you. This is love. انك تبقي في مكان زي ده وحاسة الاحاسيس دي وشايفة المناظر دي وسامعة الاصوات دي وتتنفسي الهواء ده وتشوفي المطرة اللي احنا شفناها النهاردة دي. This is definitely love.
I've been back through many phases and then I found sound healing. Mm-hmm. And it was the only thing that I wanted to pursue and share with the people. Mm-hmm. And I will share with you a quote that one of my teachers has. He says, in sound we are born and in sound we are healed. And maybe this kida will yani decipher shwaya enigma di. In sound, we are born because all creation myth suggests that life started with a sound. For example, in Christianity, you have in the Bible, first there was the word, and God said that let there be light. In Islam, kun fayakun. In Hinduism, Vedic sciences, our philosophies, there is the word Om. You know? So it's the sound of creation. Even the Big Bang is just a sound. So whatever your belief system is, all creation myths suggest that creation started with a sonorous event. And this is how we can say that in sound we are born. And then in sound we are healed because simply, guys, sound takes you back to your true self, beyond the chatter of the mind, beyond the traumas, beyond the stories, beyond the drama, beyond everything. It takes you to that place within where there is always peace, where there is always stillness. There is always wisdom. The space that we are unable to access due to, you know, all the distractions and all the chatter and all the drama, it takes you there. And it also allows you to release all impressions that stand in your way from connecting more and more and more and more to that amazing space within. Bali, for me, honestly, it represents heaven and magic. Nature is amazing, so abundant, so giving. But this time came in, I realized that it's not only the place, but the people. And there are many amazing things about the people here in Bali, but there are two things that I feel really contribute to the magic and beauty of the place. First, they are extremely kind and polite. They always smile and they are very thankful and very calm. Like you feel that they flow with nature. Mm-hmm. They have a lot of respect for each other. And the second thing, they also have a lot of respect for their ancestors and their tradition. They are connected to your roots. يعني أنت مش مخلوعة من الروتس بتاعتك. Until you are connected to your roots, but at the same time you are evolving. But evolution doesn't mean that you need to forget about where you came from. It is the base. عارفة زي بالظبط عمارة. ينفع ان انت تطلعي عمارة مثلا 100 دور من غير ما يبقى في اساس كويس. If you are not respecting your heritage, if you are not respecting your roots, if you are not connected to your heritage and to your roots, you lose a lot in your process of evolution. A lot. Mm. But this is what I love about this land. Mm.
The tantric path is always a combination of both. it says that, yeah, you're here on earth, you know, you've come, you have a human body, there's a reason, you know. And so you, the tantric path is always inviting you to thrive on both levels, you know, to not give up one for the other, for the sake of the other. So it just to, you know, just so for your general information, the main differentiation between just the pure Hatha yoga path and a tantric yoga path is that, yeah, so the yogis, like the pure Hatha yoga, is it's a path of what's it called, renunciation, you know. So you know that those images of the yogis in the caves and the Himalayas, where they're just you know, they're living their own life, they have nothing to do with anyone else, they don't have families, they don't have jobs and children or anything like that. You know that image, right, of the people in the caves? Yes. You've never heard of people in the caves who just sit and meditate all day, masalan, you know? So that's the pure yogic path, you know? It's like, so not necessarily that you end up in a cave, but it's just this feeling of like, you shed the world, you know? And you transcend all of this kind of human stuff, yeah? So the thing is, so for the average person, that's usually not the path that you want, you know? So it's usually the opposite, that you want to have both at the same time. So this is our path. So that being said, there are presets to the tantric path, kind of like principles and ruling principles.
أنا ملك. شيرين وسبا introduced me to a lot of beautiful practices and teachings. And I think the first time I practiced sound healing was with Shireen. The first time I was introduced to tantra was with Sibo. And I think both practices, I would say, changed my life. Yeah, it definitely changed my perspective on yoga. I used to practice other types, but since I got introduced to tantra, I haven't been able to practice anything else. I mean, this is my go-to yoga practice, and I'm on the path, so I love it. Sound healing is just very healing for me. It's beautiful, the place is amazing, the people are lovely. Any retreat with Shireen and Sibha, I think it's new realizations come up, you cross paths with beautiful souls. For me, I think is seeing the beauty in everything, even the tough experiences, the lessons, and then finding the beauty in everything, without attachment.
What is love for you?
Love is, for me, it's being able to be completely myself and being accepted for that, and also accepting others completely for who they are. So it's seeing someone's demons and dark sides, but also their light and all of their inner beauty, and both of these aspects coming together, being able to fully see that and still accept and want these people and those individuals in our lives, regardless of all.
Very accepting group, very nice, outgoing, and it was lovely. So yeah, I think this is the best retreat I've ever been on.
Out.